Hi, my name is Tammy Rose, and I'm the author of Lost Dreams and Lost Treasures. Both books are actually based on an old family legend. Growing up, my dad told me an intriguing story about my great-grandfather, Richard Pine. He allegedly buried gold coins worth millions of dollars beneath his property in Germany before the Russians invaded at the end of World War II. Recently, I was able to interview my dad and bring his story to life.
It's a story about lost treasure.
Something is buried in the pig barn in the back, and it's gold.
And family secrets.
They were supposed to burn it down. He was drafted in the SS.
It was a long, hard road for my dad, but after years of working hard, he finally made his way to the top. Driven by a dark, humble past, Hans Rose is now a self-made millionaire and lives on a 100-acre-plus ranch in Plymouth, Wisconsin. For as long as I can remember, he intrigued me with our rich German history, stories of lost treasure, his time spent in refugee camps, and his struggles to make it to America. He told me an intriguing tale about my great-grandfather, Richard Pine. He was a well-respected member of the community and head of the local bank in Berlitt, also the town's mayor.
When he was a little mayor of Berlitt, they said, well, you got to have the Nazi flag up. He didn't want a Nazi flag because he didn't believe in the Nazis. He was just the opposite. And you know why? Because he thought straight. He didn't believe them because he thought the Nazis were thugs. And he wouldn't put out the flag. Well, the local guy came and says, you don't put the flag out. Well, you know, you have four sons. First thing, we're going to go grab them, enlist them, and set them in the front of war.
Richard, like so many other Germans, held firm to their beliefs, but paid dearly. His youngest son, Gunther, Hans's uncle, was drafted into World War II and would meet his fate.
He was killed on the bombing raid on a bridge. He was a guard, he was a lieutenant on a bridge. They were guarding it, and that was bombed, and he was killed in St. Pölten, Austria.
Even though Richard's second oldest son, Werner, didn't support Hitler's ideas either, he wanted to fight for his country and signed up for the military police known as the White Mice.
So 6 months before Paris, they were supposed to burn it down, he was drafted in the SS. So what happened is the military guy who was ahead of him in Paris, he didn't want to take prisoners, so he just shot 100 French officers.
Even though Werner wasn't in charge and didn't order the shootings, he was sentenced to 7 years in prison for Nazi war crimes. While everyone struggled with the aftermath of World War II, the first 7 years of my dad's life wasn't all that bad.
Tiefersdorf was a town. It was a 28-room kind of mansion. It was the biggest house in the town, and that's why they had the mayor's office. It was a prestigious place.
Hans was a typical German boy getting into a fair amount of trouble, and although he had a rocky relationship with his father, he always tried to protect his dad when he could.
The mayor, that was going to put him in jail, and I didn't like that, so I grabbed my soccer ball, aimed it at the window outside, and where the mayor was sitting, I kicked it in, smashed the window. Of course, they knew who it was because my name was on the ball, and I got caught.
In fact, Hans seemed to take after his father, William, who always seemed to be getting into trouble himself.
Well, Grandpa was talking about getting rid of all the communists. They're a bad influence, and of course, talked against the state. That's treason. That's the reason they put him in jail politically. Didn't like his views. Of course, he was in and out of jail for 7 years.
His dad's imprisonment was just the beginning of a downward spiral. Soon, the aftermath of the war would catch up to the Rose family. The Russians, who occupied East Germany, took whatever land and property they could from the Germans.
He told us to get out. If we're seen within 50 miles, they'll shoot us. So we had to flee.
My dad's family lost everything and fled to Granso, where his uncle Richard Pine Jr., Richard and Helena's eldest son, lived with his wife Mariana.
And then the doctor, our family doctor, said, I'll write you a subscription because I was getting sick, that you should go to West Germany and escape East Germany because they're going to close the border.
It was here at this house in Berlin my dad would learn an interesting family legend from his Uncle Richard, one that would inspire me to write several books, but we'll get to that part of the story later.
I was so skinny that the doctors thought I was going to die.
For the next 3 years, my father spent living in refugee camps with his mother, his sister, Helga, and his brother, Reinhard. His father was still in an East German prison making tanks for the Russian soldiers.
When we had no food, what did I do? I went out in the streets and I stole food for us. I stole oranges, apples, bananas, or whatever I could steal.
It was at the Traunstein refugee camp where Hans almost lost his life, but also a turning point for the young German boy.
In a refugee camp, you're lucky to get food once a day. And, you know, what are you going to do when you have no food?
After almost starving to death, my dad and his family were sponsored by the World Church Council and were able to immigrate to the United States in 1957. It was then he promised himself and his family that he would never go hungry again and spent his life building an empire for himself here in America. First owning a travel agency with his wife Joanne, then dabbling in real estate. But there is one piece of unfinished business left Rose has yet to conquer, and that brings us back to the house, once owned by the Pine family, also my family, a secret his Uncle Richard had told him before he died.
Something is buried in the pig barn in the back, and it's gold. It's the gold pieces that his grandfather buried. In other words, had in the First World War. So these gold coins are original German gold coins.
Since I was a little girl, my dad had told me about the story of our buried treasure and his hopes of one day recovering some of our property.
I believe there's a lot of truth to it. The problem is it there? We're never going to find out unless we own it someday.
And that is my hope, my dream. So I carry with me some advice my great-grandfather gave to my dad.
My favorite grandpa was Herman Rose, my dad's father, most gentle, most kindest man ever lived. Taught me a lot of good things, to be honest and brave, and just never quit, just keep on going. No matter what they tell you, keep on going, and that's why I've always done my life.